Primary production underwriting for Check Please Kansas City has been provided by Bank of America, Bank of Opportunity. Additional funding for Check Please Kansas City is provided by 360 Vodka, the world's first eco-friendly premium vodka, saving the planet one glass at a time.
You know, I'm a seafood junkie.
Let's talk dessert.
Banana split.
I don't ever remember taking anything home. I eat the whole thing.
They're never ending. You can never get to the bottom of them.
It was just fantastic. Yeah, it was very, very good.
Pumpkin ravioli, it's a disgusting food. It's a disgusting vegetable.
What was more unusual was I thoroughly enjoyed it.
It's become like a home away from home.
I have to admit, it's off the beaten path.
Way off the beaten path.
Yeah, it is.
Hello, I'm Doug Frost, and welcome to Check Please Kansas City, the show where regular folks from all over Kansas City dine and then dish on their favorite restaurants. This is how the show works. Every week, we have three guests. Each recommends his or her favorite spot while the other two go and check them out to see what they think. This week, college student Dylan Wilkerson says the atmosphere and service, let alone the fresh food, are reason enough to visit his Zona Rosa pick. Director-actor Missy Coons says her pick in Prairie Village adds spice and fun to any dining experience. Now, studio manager Matt McClellan claims that as a Kansas City barbecue aficionado, you can do no better than Rosedale Barbecue on Southwest Boulevard.
Rosedale was founded in 1934, July 4th to be exact, by my grandparents, Alden Anthony Rickey, and my great uncle, Anthony Seelman. Rosedale Barbecue is your traditional Kansas City barbecue. It's very laid back, come as you are, family friendly, with a little nostalgia thrown in. If you look at the walls at Rosedale Barbecue, you'll see old vintage articles that kind of tell the timeline, the history. We pride ourselves on true barbecue fare. Everything from your traditional barbecue beef sandwiches, the turkey sandwich, the pig pen is a great combination of flavors, to a full rack of ribs, which is of course a Rosedale specialty. The service is very fast and friendly. Our employees are longtime employees, part of the Rosedale barbecue family. People can come in for anything from large carryout orders, a simple 30-minute lunch for business. You got to get away from lunch. We can get you in and out. Come in, try Rosedale, and we hope to see you a second, third, fourth time.
Matt, as you know, this is a barbecue town. So how come you pick Rosedale Barbecue?
Well, I like a lot of barbecue places in Kansas City.
Well, yeah.
We have
a lot of
a group amongst the crew that where we go, we call ourselves the Briskettes. We try as many barbecue places as we can get to in an hour and get back from lunch.
Nice. Back. I like this.
But Rosedale's is not crazy fancy.
Well, it's just
It's just exactly what you want in a barbecue place.
Which is?
I mean, you get a sandwich, there's never any gristle in it, you never get any fat, it's a beef sandwich, it's all lean beef. The sauce is incredible. There's some alchemy going on there. I'm not quite sure what the sauce is. I've heard lots of rumors about various secret ingredients.
Cool. So beef sandwich, is that it for you, or are you ribs, or where are you going?
I eat everything on the menu, depending on when I go. I usually get either the beef sandwich and the sausage sandwich, or I get the long end and fries. And the sausage and the beef sandwiches are wonderful. They come on soggy white bread, which I really love. I mean, there's no brioche buns here or ciabatta bread.
It's would not be barbecue.
They do have a bun for people that like such things. I don't know why, but they have them. And then the fries are just like super crispy every single time. I've been going to Rosedale since I was 6 years old, and I've never once had a bad meal.
10, 15 years then, something like
yeah,
that?
Yeah, something like that.
No, I thought so.
Maybe twice that. And I've never had a bad meal there.
All right. Well, Dylan, what do you think?
I didn't like it too much.
Yeah, really. Tell us why.
The sports bar atmosphere is fine, and I liked the food. It was just because of my medical history, my cancer, I can't have pork, so I didn't find many options for me.
Really?
I had the burnt ends.
Oh, cool.
I tasted burnt ends, too.
Yep. And how were the burnt ends?
Good. It was all good.
Yeah?
Just not a lot of options.
Well, the beef sandwich is really their star, I think.
I didn't see it.
Yeah, it's.
Oh no!
Christ! Now you have to go back.
Yeah, exactly. Reason to go back. Tell us about the chicken dinner, though. The one that you.
Oh, it was good. Mm-hmm. It's half a chicken, with a side of coleslaw, beans, and fries. I liked the fries. Mm-hmm. I'm a potato lover.
Indeed. And Missy, what'd you have?
Oh, let's see, I like to get mix it up with the combo. I had beef and turkey, and of course the crinkle cut fries. I mean, you can't beat a crinkle cut fry.
Those are little old school.
It's old school. And I mean, you know, if you don't mind eating off a paper plate.
It's part of the scene, right?
Oh, absolutely. And it's messy, and they put plenty of napkins on the table.
So tell us more
about
it.
I think
it's
a great place to get things to go. That's what I like Rosedale for. But, you know, it's a cute place to hang out. And one thing is you can go as you are. I mean, it doesn't matter what you're wearing. Wear a ball cap. You can wear your pajamas.
Maybe with sports paraphernalia, to Dylan's point. I mean,
yes.
It does have, you know, that
exactly.
It sports, you know.
But it's laid back, comfortable.
Mm-hmm. I think next time I think I'd take it to go.
And so service, what was service like for you two? What do you think, Dylan?
But I'd say good. They're nice and friendly.
They're nice. They're friendly. It comes out fast. It's
fast is really the main thing, because you can go down there and there's a line out both doors, both sides of the restaurant, and you'll get your food and get in about 5-10 minutes.
Well, it depends on when you go there. I went there at 8 o'clock at night.
Was there a line?
There was nobody there.
Oh, well, that's the perfect time.
Yeah, I like to go after lunch, like around
1:30
when the lunch rush is over. Then you don't have to stand in that line.
Missy, tell us more about exactly, you know, what you think about each dish, what you've had.
Well, I'm not the biggest fan of the sauce. I mean, it's not my favorite sauce in Kansas City. It's a little too molassesy, or the brown sugar, something sweet
kind
in there.
Kind of tastes cinnamon.
Yeah.
Oh, is that right? Cinnamon.
Yeah.
It's
definitely cinnamon in it.
Yeah, the molasses and the cinnamon. It's a little too much of that, but for the buck, I mean, it's the most affordable barbecue in town, and it's still very tasty. And like I said, the crinkle cut fries, those are the way to go.
I've smuggled Rosedales into hospitals. I've smuggled Rosedales all sorts of places for various people. And I've taken sauce on airplanes. And
nice.
The Rosedale smuggler.
Now we know.
Barbecue bandit.
Bang for the buck, what do you think, Dylan?
It was good.
Yep.
I would recommend it to my friends in college.
Cool. Yeah, especially for the value then.
Yes.
Matt?
If you go to other places, you can get a really gigantic sandwich at like Gates or Bryant's, but it's an investment, you know, 10 bucks or something. Rosedale's, their sandwiches are manageable, you know, and the price is excellent. And, you know, if you want more, just get two.
Cool.
Bang for the buck is awesome.
Cool. Well, Matt, it was your place. Why don't you sum it up for us?
I'd say when you want to have a religious experience with a bag of fries, a pile of meat, and a puddle of sauce, this is the place. It's not the only barbecue joint in town, but you cannot go wrong at Rosedale's Barbecue.
And Dylan, equal time for opposing views?
Not a lot of options, but had really good food. And I would probably go there again if I really wanted barbecue chicken or a beef sandwich.
Cool. And Missy?
You can't keep me away from the Rosedale. I'll be back, you bet.
Cool, well try it for yourself at Rosedale Barbecue, 600 Southwest Boulevard, Kansas City, Kansas. Their phone number is 913-262-0343. They're open Monday and Tuesday, 10 a.m. to 7 p.m. Wednesday until 8 p.m., Thursday till 9 p.m., Friday 10 a.m. to 10 p.m., Saturday from 11 a.m. to 10 p.m., and Sunday 11 a.m. to 8 p.m. Reservations are accepted for large parties, and the average dinner tab per person without drinks is $10. College student Dylan Wilkerson says the comfort and service is second only to the first-rate Kansas City Strip at Hereford House in Zona Rosa.
Hereford House has been a Kansas City tradition since 1957, serving the best steaks in the Midwest. We've got an upscale casual ambiance. We're a classic American steakhouse, old-time Midwest hospitality, very relaxed, casual atmosphere. It's just a really friendly, fun place to come, where you can kick back, enjoy. If you want steak, you can find it at Hereford House. We feature prime rib, bone-in ribeyes, Kansas City strips, T-bones, filet mignon. We also have some other great items on our menu, pork chops. We've got grilled salmon. We can usually find something you'll like, including a vegetarian plate if you really want one.
We do most of our items here in-house. I think it's very special. Whatever you want, we can do it. It's very, very simple for the chefs to just put it together for you. If you want a different cut steak, we can do that for you.
When people come to Hereford House, we want them to feel relaxed. It's not just about getting a meal. It's about experiencing part of Kansas City.
Okay, Dylan, tell us what you like about Herford House.
I liked, they have two sections, the bar section, which I like the shape of the bar, and also the atmosphere around it, as well as the dining section, which has some very interesting prints. They're not actual paintings, but prints.
What sort of food do you like to have? Is it Kansas City Strip all the time, or is there are there other things you want?
I get burgers, strips, chicken, just a lot of stuff. But I think my favorite thing there is their potatoes.
Which?
The mashed potatoes.
I see.
And their fries.
Yeah.
I'm just going to go with potatoes in general.
Can you give us a little more detail about the strip itself, what you like, you know, let's say what you like about the Kansas City Strip?
I have to have it well done just because of my medical history again. Mm. The strip that I had was well done and tasted the crispy, charred taste on the outside, but it was still juicy on the inside.
Yeah, perfect.
It required no sauce whatsoever.
Those guys have been at it a long time. You would think they would have it right, and I think they do, for sure. Did you have a dessert? I guess there was a cake that you had there that...
Yes, it was a chocolate tower cake.
Oh, really?
It kind of had the consistency of cake and brownie put together.
That doesn't sound bad to anyone here. Apparently, that elicits all sorts of noises.
With chocolate sauce on it, too.
Oh, of course. Well, Missy, what did you have? Did you enjoy Herford House?
Well, I'm always looking for the secret happy hour spots, the best places to go get the most reasonable and secret specials all across town. And the Herford House, I got very happy there. They have a delightful happy hour, and it starts at 3:30. The cocktails are on special. They have specialty cocktails, about 9 different martinis that are on special. The happy hour food menu is everything is some below $10 for the most part. I mean, we did the steak sandwich and the French dip sliders, which were absolutely delicious. This was no pressed packaged meat that were on these sliders there. You can't get any better than that.
Matt, what'd you have?
Well, we started with the crab cakes, and I'm a kind of a snob about crab cakes. I have family from Maryland, and so real sweet.
So we're already at a loss, right? Because nobody touches
Maryland. 2,000 miles from the nearest ocean.
Baltimore is it. Yeah.
But no, they were really good. And then I had the ribeye, the king of steaks, and then we had mashed potatoes and asparagus, and I had the béarnaise sauce on the ribeye, which I thought was really good, and my wife had the salmon, which I never would order salmon in a restaurant, but it was excellent.
Why would you do that?
My mom, ordered the salmon, and I tasted it, and it was good.
It was very good. I was surprised. It was a very kind of Kansas City dining experience because you know, everybody in the whole place was wearing jeans. It's kind of upscale, the prices are fine dining a little bit. And there was not one person in the building wearing anything other than jeans. And, you know, like some restaurants you go in, there's like a certain steak with a certain sauce and another steak with another sauce. Not here. You get your steak, you pick your steak, and then you pick your sauce. And so you can order as much sauce as you want. And it was made me happy.
And what do you think about the service there?
Oh, I had a good server. Because he was very good on his recommendations. He actually recommended the potatoes over the fries and the dessert.
And Missy, what do you think about service there?
You know, they don't hover over you, but they don't stay away too long. So it was just the right amount of attention. We didn't have to worry about our glasses being empty or needing anything.
Dylan, what did you think of the value there?
Oh, I thought it was kind of pricey for my budget.
Yeah, so more of a special occasion place than it is a weekend.
Wouldn't recommend it to my friends.
they'd get mad unless you were covering it.
Now, for the happy hour, I mean, that's a great bang for your buck. If you go at happy hour, you're looking at really reasonable prices on the food, and the portions were great for those prices. It wasn't like they scaled them down to minute, minuscule portions because you were paying $5.95 for it or whatever. So, I mean, I think for your friends, perhaps happy hour would be the way to go. Sans the drinks, of course.
So there may be some value available there. Dylan.
Yeah. I should look at that.
And Matt, bang for the buck?
It's not a go, you know, for lunch every day kind of place. But we had wine, we had steaks, we had salmon and crab cakes, and I thought the bill was pretty reasonable for what we ate.
Cool. Well, Dylan, it was your restaurant. Do you mind summing it up for us?
Good decor, good atmosphere, wonderful food. I guess depending on when you go, wonderful price. I think it has a good rating.
Wonderful.
I'd go there again.
Yeah, and Matt?
It's a kind of a classic Kansas City dining experience. It's you know, the food is a little upscale, but the dining experience is not. It's uncomplicated. It's sort of makes you, it's just everything you want it to be. I enjoyed it immensely.
And Missy?
Well, I always like to support those Kansas City original restaurants, and I love that the Hereford House is a Kansas City original and that you can get some good value or you can go out for a special occasion and spend the dough, and there's all those options there. So you gotta love the Hereford House.
Wonderful. Well, try a KC original for yourself at Hereford House, Zona Rosa, 8661 North Stoddard Avenue, Kansas City, Missouri. Their phone number is 816-584-9000. They're open Monday through Thursday from 11 a.m. to 9 p.m., Friday until 10 p.m. Saturday, they're open noon to 10 p.m., and Sunday, 10 a.m. to 9 p.m. Reservations are accepted, and the average dinner tab per person without drinks is $35. We had such a great time on our last KCPT Night on the Town that we simply had to do it again. So last September, we visited four restaurants in Midtown, and this time, on Tuesday, May 24th, J.J. Mirabile and I are joining you on two Kansas City trolleys, and we're headed to Johnson County with restaurants like Jasper's and the Roastery Cafe, and I think we should see you there. Director-actor Missy Koontz says her pick in Prairie Village adds dramatic spice and theatrical flair to any dining experience. Did you actually say that too? No, I didn't think so.
Coco Pele was established in 2004.
We went to Santa Fe. We'd go there for my birthday every year, and we got this brooch and it had a Coco Pele on it. Neither of us knew anything about it. The reason behind it was so incredibly fun that we're like, the next restaurant, this is gonna be what we're gonna do. And the love god was Coco Pele, and that's what we put. We have met a lot of wonderful people through this restaurant. It's very casual. You could come in with a business suit. You could come in with shorts and a t-shirt. We have great food. We have really gourmet shrimp enchiladas, fish tacos. We use tilapia. That's one of our biggest sellers.
And then, of course, we got all the normal stuff like tostadas, tacos, and tamales.
Our service is amazing. You know, we've had the same people for a lot of years.
We really focus on making sure that the customer leaves happy. We are part of the Kansas City Originals. So what's nice about it is us being independently owned and operated, you're going to find the owners here on staff. So if you haven't tried us, please come out and dine with us. And make sure you introduce yourself to Tammy or Kevin.
Missy, give us some improv on how you feel about Coco Pele Mexican Cantina.
Well, what I like about it, you know, Coco Pele is another Kansas City original restaurant.
Yes, it
and
is.
The owners are always there and they're working, and I like to see that in a restaurant, that the people are there and they care about it and they've got their finger on the pulse of the quality and making sure that everybody's happy and everybody's very casual, friendly. If you didn't go with someone, you could make a new friend. I like that about a place.
So what do you usually like to have, you and your new friend?
Well, me and my new friends, we like to have the fish tacos or the shrimp tacos.
Oh, yeah.
I had the shrimp tacos this particular time with a tamale, which are house made. We started out with some Santa Fe cheese dip, which is their specialty cheese dip with spinach and secret ingredients is what they say.
Are you a margarita girl?
Didn't have the margarita. We have the sangritas there.
Uh-huh.
The sangritas, that's the margarita with the swirl of sangria.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, delicious.
I'm thinking more than one.
Definitely more than one, but you have to be careful because they can kind of sneak up on you a little bit.
Matt, did you have a lot of things?
I did. The waitress
yes,
was like,
smile
she
too.
Kept trying to walk off, and I'm like, but wait, there's more. So I had the pork and bean burrito with the chili verde on it. I had the sour cream chicken enchiladas. I had the crab enchiladas, a side of rice, and I had margaritas, which were very good. Normally, margaritas in restaurants have sour mix in them because it's right. cheaper than lime juice, and they think they're doing something in it.
And it's maybe not even cheaper. They just think it's cheaper.
Well, lime juice is almost as much as tequila, so why they do it. And I'd say they're the second best margarita in Kansas City. And
ooh,
I really enjoyed that.
That's big praise.
And my wife had the fish tacos, which normally I don't like, and I thought those were really good, too.
Yeah, they're good.
Yeah.
Good. Any dessert?
Yes, we had the Choco Chimichanga. Which normally I don't do desserts at restaurants all the time, but you know, for Check Please, we had to do it.
We appreciate you taking the bullet for us that way.
It was very good too.
Dylan, what'd you have?
I had the create your own combo,
mm-hmm.
but I had the beef taco, cheese enchilada, and I think it's the flauta,
mm-hmm.
the beef flauta. They're all good.
Any standouts? The flautas? Was it beef flauta or cheese flauta? It was the beef flauta. Yeah, good.
I kind of ate the next day.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, I kind
had
of
had extras.
Yeah, I boxed up, think the cheese enchilada and the flauta, and I just had that for breakfast the next morning.
How'd it taste the next morning? I think that's a fair way
right?
to judge a restaurant.
Absolutely.
Exactly. With enough salsa, I'm down with that.
You're still good. I think the lettuce was kind of bad after going through the microwave, but...
Oh, hot lettuce is the worst.
Oh, no. Other than that, it was still good.
Cool. Very good.
You know, obviously, I ordered two of everything, so I had leftovers the next day. And when I was eating the pork and bean burrito, it wasn't my favorite. Mm-hmm. And the sour cream enchiladas were really... kind of a star. But then the next morning, after we'd had a few shots of Patron at the bar on the way out the door and a couple pitchers of margaritas, that pork and bean burrito was awesome the next day in the microwave. So
it's a good sign.
I have to give them a good credit for a second effort.
Yeah, indeed.
Yeah.
So how about location? Was it's a far drive for you. What
yeah,
do you think?
Yeah, it was 45 minutes for me. And when I were trying to find it, we drove past it because we first thought it was a laundromat. Then we had to like make a U-turn. We're like, is that it? Really?
Yeah, it is kind of hidden from the street. There's mm-hmm. no question. Missy, how about you? What's the location like for you? Is that nearby for you or something?
No, it's not nearby for me, but it's worth the drive. I don't know. When the things are good, then you drive for them. So there's not a lot of Mexican restaurants that I like. I like them because they make everything fresh and homemade. There's a lot of different kinds of choices. If you stray off the beaten path, I think that you score a lot better by getting their specialties as opposed to something that you could get anywhere.
Yeah. Matt, what do you think of the location?
Well, I live up north, so, and I have to drive by a lot of really great Mexican places on Southwest Boulevard to get there, but I thought once I was there, it was very good.
Well, Dylan, what'd you think? Bang for the buck.
It was good bang for the buck. Mm-hmm. I think it made two meals out of the price of one, which is always good.
Yeah, it is indeed. And Missy?
Oh yeah, there's always stuff to take home. If you don't go there enough to know how much to order so that you don't leave with the box, then you probably will leave with the box. And I think the value is great.
And how about you, Matt?
I thought bang for the buck. You know, it was priced pretty much consistently with Mexican restaurants in town. We got lots of food. We were very full. The guacamole was excellent. The margaritas were excellent. You know, everything came out right on time.
All right. Missy, well, why don't you give us your curtain call on Cocopelli?
Cocopelli, well, it's a great Kansas City original, which we always want to support. And fresh, homemade, house-made items. It's a great value. It's maybe not the most convenient location for everybody, but it's worth the trip. The sangritas are to die for. It's an upbeat atmosphere where you can tell everyone is just pretty much happy to be there.
Wonderful. Well, you decide for yourself at Cocopelli Mexican Cantina, 5200 West 95th Street in Prairie Village, Kansas. The phone number is 913-385-0300. They're open Sunday through Thursday, 11 a.m. to 9 p.m., Friday and Saturday from 11 a.m. to 10 p.m. Reservations are accepted, and the average dinner tab per person without drinks is $12. So on this week's show, we featured Rosedale Barbecue on Southwest Boulevard. Dylan said the chicken is worth returning for. Missy said it's the best barbecue bang for buck in Kansas City. And Matt said he smuggled the sauce across the country. And we featured Herfin House in Zona Rosa. Dylan said they have great steaks for special occasions. Missy said the happy hour has a great bang for buck. And Matt said it's a Kansas City classic with cowboy chic. Finally, we featured Cocopelli Mexican Restaurant in Prairie Village. Dylan said it had pretty good Mexican food. Missy said they have great food that's fresh and homemade. And Matt said, once you get there, it's great. We've had a wonderful time this week. I want to thank my guests, Dylan Wilkerson, Matt McClelland, and Missy Coons. Please join us next week for three new guests recommending three of their favorite restaurants right here on Check Please Kansas City. I'm Doug Frost, and I will see you then. Cheers to y'all.
Indeed. Thanks, y'all, for putting up with all the craziness. It wasn't too bad. Wine is the standard, so I went long. Yeah, we get the meat. Oh, we can't talk to you.
Primary production underwriting for Check Please Kansas City has been provided by Bank of America, Bank of Opportunity. Additional funding for Check Please Kansas City is provided by 360 Vodka, the world's first eco-friendly premium vodka, saving the planet one glass at a time.